هو الأمين وافقي حمدا لمن هداني لسنة العدنان محمد.
So Muslims were in the forefront of scientific, mathematical achievements. Right, I mean algebra, chemistry's development, the concept of zero being taken from Hindus, putting into practice. Even the numbering system we have today is based on Islamic numbering, not on the Roman numerals, right? A lot of the developments Muslims made in Europe were in Spain. And under Andalus, as you can research yourself, Muslims, Christians, Jews lived in peace, right? And they were able to work together, they were able to develop together. There were Muslim scientists and mathematicians and theologians who worked with others in developing ideas. One of the paintings of Mary from the Renaissance, you will find her wearing a scarf. If you look at the edge of the scarf, you will find La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, the Islamic testimony of faith painted there. Look this up when you go home, because you're a researcher.
I am a researcher.
I'd like you to research the influence of the Quran on the Western Renaissance. You know, when you graduate, what do you wear? Right here,
cap and gown.
You wear a cap and you wear a gown with a fez on it. And if you research this tradition, this came because people in the West used to go to Cairo, to Azhar, and they used to study knowledge. And when they came back wearing the Islamic robe and the cap with the fez, it was taken as a sign of them graduating or bringing back that knowledge to the West. And that's where this tradition came from, the idea of cameras, right? And inverting the picture.
Yeah.
This was developed by a Muslim who put a pinhole. Western researchers then researched his work, brought it back to Europe and developed.
فشق صدره الزكي أخرج منه قلبه بزمزم طهره وبعدما نقاه بحكمة حشاه أتى حليمة الخبر من كل طفل قد حضر وكلهم قد نقلا محمد قد قتل وحين عاد أخبر بما رأى وما جرى فانزعجت حليمة من هذه العظيمة وردت الصبية لأمه رضيا وراح للمدينة مع أمه أمينة إلى بني النجار أخواله الأخير.